May the 14th, 1993.
From NBC News, this is Today with Bryant Gumbel and Catherine Couric.
And good morning. Welcome to Today on this Friday morning, heading into what we hope is a good weekend in the merry month of May. Margaret Larson's going to bring us up to speed on the tax package, about $250 million in new revenue to be derived from that package. She'll bring us up to speed on that and other matters. And then we've got a cavalcade of stars for the next 2 hours.
We sure do. Jamie Gangel has snagged a rare interview with a reclusive Frank Zappa, who's zany as ever, but dealing with prostate cancer. So it's quite an interesting interview. I'm going to be talking with Ted Danson as we count down to the final episode of Cheers next week. And Emma Thompson. I hear you.
Yeah.
Anyway, moving right along, Frank Zappa doesn't give a lot of television interviews because he doesn't like being interviewed either. But Jamie Gangel has one with him this morning. It may surprise a lot of people to learn that the mad rocker who led the Mothers of Invention is writing serious music these days, even an opera, as he continues to fight against cancer.
He is really a brilliant guy.
Yes.
He's very smart. Let's 7:35. Frank Zappa is next, right after this.
You know, to some, Frank Zappa is a legend in rock music. To others, he's a bizarre performer with a penchant for lascivious lyrics. But what few realize is that he's also a serious and respected classical composer. Today's show national correspondent Jamie Gangel is here this morning with a rare interview with Frank Zappa, an interview that almost didn't happen because Frank Zappa is also quite ill. Jamie, how's he doing?
He's not doing well. He's been suffering from prostate cancer for a number of years, and we really got the impression that it took all of his strength to even do this interview. And although he guards his privacy, he talked about his cancer, and in spite of it all, at 52, Frank Zappa is still Frank Zappa, funny, opinionated, and off the wall.
This is the Frank Zappa most people think of. The Mothers of Invention. Outrageous rock and roll. Outrageous videos.
I don't understand.
And just plain outrageous. But for the last 4 years, Zappa has focused on classical music. Almost unheard in America, he sells out concert halls in Europe.
Tell me about the Yellow Shark concert. It got an extraordinary reaction.
It's chamber music for a 25-piece group. Within the 25 pieces, we had compositions of different sizes, ranging from music for two pianos, woodwind quintet, string quintet, the full ensemble, things that featured percussion. We use things like, you know, these little toy cow moose, these things you turn upside down. We use those, and we had little plastic ray guns that were part of the sound. It was a variety show.
You got an extraordinary reaction. I mean, 20-minute standing ovations, both the nights that you were there and were not there. How'd you feel about that?
Well, as I said to you a little earlier, there's no accounting for taste.
Oh, come on. You must have been thrilled.
I was sick, so it's hard to be truly thrilled, but I was happier that they did that rather than throw things at the stage.
How long have you been playing bike, Frank?
About 2 weeks.
As long as you've been doing this, though, you've been doing everything from, what, playing a bicycle to using your nephew's burping.
A talented young man.
Behind all the different use of sound?
Well, basically sounds are for listening to, and composition is the act of organizing sounds. The challenge of collecting and organizing unusual sounds along with the ordinary musical sounds is something that I enjoy doing.
These days, Zappa's favorite instrument is the synclavier, a computerized keyboard that stores thousands of sounds.
I don't know if it's even fair to ask how much of it is for the sound and how much of it was for the humor.
Both. You know, I think it's the goal here is entertainment.
You have made a career out of making fun of everybody, gays, Jewish American princesses, and you have taken a lot of heat for it. Does that bother you at all?
No, I'm totally unrepentant.
Is there anything you ever did that you were sorry for in music?
No.
A lot of performers do things that are shocking or might be considered obscenity or pornography. But you get singled out a lot, I think. Do you have any idea why?
Because I'm ugly.
Oh, stop.
Well, you know, in this world of basic stereotyping, give a guy a big nose and some weird hair, and he's capable of anything.
For the two people who might not remember, it wasn't too long ago that on Capitol Hill, as we say in Washington, you had frank and full discussions on the issue of record labeling with one Tipper Gore.
We now propose one generic warning label to inform consumers in the marketplace about lyric content.
The establishment of a rating system, voluntary or otherwise, opens the door to an endless parade of moral quality control programs.
Did it make you feel better about her when it was revealed during the campaign that she was a drummer in an all-girl band, the Wildcats? Did that give you a new...
No, I never heard that one, but I can...
You didn't know that?
No.
She got a new set of drums for Christmas this year.
Oh, the one day I wasn't watching the news.
Now, does that give you a new feeling for
yeah,
her?
Yeah, I got a perspective on it now.
Have you heard from them since then?
Well, when it was revealed that I was sick, I got a nice letter from the Gores.
You're a legendary workaholic. Are you able to work?
Not anymore.
Not anymore. Tell me.
Basically, on a good day, I can go 9:30 to 6:30.
It's really slowed you down.
Yeah.
Has being sick affected your music, what kind of music you're writing?
No. Well, I don't do vocals.
Can you tell me a little bit about how you've been doing?
Fair.
Fair.
Yeah, good days, bad days.
More bad days than good days?
Yeah.
I gather that yours was not caught early.
That's right.
Is there anything that you want to say to people about prostate cancer?
Well, I think that it's worthwhile being examined to find out whether or not you've got it. But then on the other hand, over a period of years, I had urinary problems and was examined, and they didn't find it. And so that's why it came as such a shock to me when they told me that I had it, because I'd had urinary problems for a number of years. And you can imagine how irate a person might be when you are informed that, yeah, you got it, and we can't operate on it. So, yeah, go have a test, but get another test. Get a few tests.
Now, I know you're going to say I'm one of these health police people, but...
Go ahead.
I can't help but sit here and you have cancer and you're smoking cigarettes. Ask, Didn't it discourage you at all?
No.
Why not?
Because I don't believe that all of the stories about the evil effects of tobacco are true. And I would say, to me, a cigarette is food. Tobacco is my favorite vegetable.
And drugs are?
It's usually I say that the taking of drugs is a license to be an a**, which is the same reason why people drink.
Let me go through a list of words that whenever you read about Frank Zappa, you hear, and tell me how they strike you. Rock legend.
It's pathetic.
Test pilot pushing the edge.
That's...
Don't you like that one a little bit?
No.
No?
Yeah, it's a little bit too, got that military aroma to it.
Eccentric genius.
Eccentric, yes. Genius, maybe.
Funny guy.
Only to a few.
Here's the question, you'll know exactly what it is, and that is, how does Frank Zappa want to be remembered?
It's not important.
Not important at all?
Mm-mm.
Want to be remembered for the music?
It's not important to even be remembered. I mean, the people who worry about being remembered are guys like Reagan, Bush. These people want to be remembered. And they'll spend a lot of money and do a lot of work to make sure that remembrance is just terrific.
And for Frank Zappa?
I don't care.
Despite his health and the fact he says he's slowed down, his classical concert Yellow Shark will be released this summer. And next year in Vienna, a Frank Zappa opera will have its world premiere.
Wow, Jamie, he looks like he was a very tough interview.
It was very hard for him. He was very nice to us and really very friendly. But it was all he could do to get through that interview. He was really feeling sick that day.
When we read about Frank Zappa, you know, in years gone by, you always heard about his kids with the crazy names like Moon Unit and Dweezil. How are his children doing, and are they being really helpful and supportive during this tough time?
They're great kids, all four of them. There are two more, Amit, who likes to tell you his name rhymes with vomit, and Diva. They all live at home. It's a very close-knit family, and they've really helped to take care of him. But it's hard on them, understandably.
All right, Jamie Gengel, thank you. That was really nice
job.
Thank
you. Thanks.